और आज इनको शादी की सारी विधि चला रही है। हरे कृष्ण। Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Hare Hare Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Narayanam Namaskritya Narayanam Narottamam Devim Saraswati Vyasam Tato Jaya Mudirai Nashta Prayeshu Abhadreshu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavate Yutam Loke Bhakte Bhavati Nanishtike. तो हम लोग अभी श्रीमद् भागवतम से पढ़ रहे हैं जो छठी स्कंद है 19वीं अध्याय और द टाइटल इज कुंभ सवन रिटुअलिस्टिक सेरेमनी. श्री राजोवाच व्रतम कुंभ सवनम ब्राह्मण भवता यत् उदीरितं तस्य वेदितुम् इच्छामि येन विष्णु प्रसीदते. सो यू हैव 28 श्लोक. इफ यू रीड ऑल ऑफ इट इन संस्कृत इट विल टेक लॉन्ग. आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू गो थ्रू द इंग्लिश ट्रांसलेशन. सो महाराज परीक्षित सेड, माय डियर लॉर्ड, यू हैव ऑलरेडी स्पोकन अबाउट द कुंभ सवन वाव. नाउ आई वांट टू हियर अबाउट इट इन डिटेल, फॉर आई अंडरस्टैंड दैट बाय ऑब्जर्विंग दिस वाव वन कैन प्लीज द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड विष्णु. सुखदेव गोस्वामी सेड, on the first day of the bright fortnight of the month of Agrahayan, November-December, for the instruction of her husband, a woman should begin this regulative devotional service with a vow of penance, for it can fulfill all one's desires. Before beginning the worship of Lord Vishnu, the woman should hear the story of how the Maruts were born under the instructions of qualified Brahmanas. In the morning, she should wash her teeth,
bathe and dress herself with white
cloth and ornaments, and before taking breakfast she should worship Lord Vishnu and Lakshmi. She should then pray to the Lord as follows: My dear Lord, you are full in all opulences, but I do not beg for you for opulence. I simply offer my respectful obeisances unto you. You are the husband and master of Lakshmi Devi, the goddess of fortune, who has all opulences. Therefore you are the master of all mystic yoga. I simply offer my obeisances unto you. O my Lord, because you are endowed with causeless mercy, all opulences, all prowess and all glories, strength and transcendental qualities, you are the supreme personality of Godhead, the master of everyone. After profusely offering obeisances unto Lord Vishnu, the devotee should offer respectful obeisances unto Mother Lakshmi, the goddess of fortune, and pray as follows: O wife of Lord Vishnu, O internal energy of Lord Vishnu, you are as good as Lord Vishnu himself. For you have all of his qualities and opulences. O goddess of fortune, please be kind to me. O mother of the entire world, I offer my respectful obeisances unto you. My Lord Vishnu, full with six opulences, you are the best of all enjoyers and the most powerful. O husband of Mother Lakshmi, I offer my respectful obeisances unto you, who are accompanied by many associates of Adipakshena. I offer all the paraphernalia for worshipping you. One should chant this mantra every day with great attention while worshipping Lord Vishnu with all paraphernalia such as water for washing his feet, hands and mouth, and water for his bath. One must offer him various presentations for his worship such as garments, sacred thread, ornaments, scents, flowers, incense and lamps. That's what we did for this ceremony, Prabhuji. Shukadeva Goswami continued, after worshipping the Lord with all the paraphernalia mentioned above, one should chant the following mantra while offering 12 oblations of ghee on the sacred fire. This is what we did. Om Namo Bhagavate Mahapurushaya Mahavibhuti Pataye Swaha. This is what we just did. If one desires all opulences, his duty is to daily worship Lord Vishnu with his wife Lakshmi. With great devotion, one should worship him according to the above mentioned process. Lord Vishnu and the goddess of fortune are all an immensely powerful combination. They are the best stores of all benedictions and the sources of all good fortune. Therefore, the duty of everyone is to worship Lakshmi Narayan. One should offer obeisances unto the Lord with a mind humbled through devotion. While offering dandavats, by falling on the ground like a rod, one should chant the above mantra 10 times. Then one should chant the following prayer. My Lord Vishnu and Mother Lakshmi, goddess of fortune, you are the proprietors of the entire creation. Indeed, you are the cause of the creation. Mother Lakshmi is extremely difficult to understand because she is so powerful that the jurisdiction of her power is difficult to overcome. Mother Lakshmi is represented in the material world as the external energy. but actually she's always the internal energy of the Lord. My Lord, you are the master of energy and therefore you are the supreme person. Your sacrifice personified, this is what we're doing. Offering to Bhagavan Vishnu. Narayan. Lakshmi, the embodiment of spiritual activities, the original form of worship offered unto you, whereas you are the enjoyer of all sacrifices. Mother Lakshmi, who is here, is the reservoir of all spiritual qualities, whereas you manifest and enjoy all these qualities. Indeed, you are actually the enjoyer of everything. You live as the super soul of all living entities, and the goddess of fortune is the form of their bodies, senses and minds. She also has a holy name and form, whereas you are the support of all such names and forms and the cause for their manifestation. You are both the supreme rulers and benedictors of the three worlds. Therefore, my Lord, Uttam Shloka, may my ambitions be fulfilled by your grace. Sri Shukdev Goswami continued, thus one should worship Lord Vishnu, who is known as Srinivas, along with Mother Lakshmi, the goddess of fortune, by offering prayers according to the process mentioned above. After removing all the paraphernalia of worship, one should offer them water to wash their hands and mouth, and then one should worship them again. Therefore, with devotion and humility, one should offer prayers to the Lord and Mother Lakshmi. Then one should smell the remnants of the food offered and then again worship the Lord and Lakshmiji. Accepted husband are the representative of the Supreme Person. With instruction to you now. A wife should worship him with unalloyed devotion by offering him prasad. The husband, being very pleased with his wife, should engage himself in the affairs of his family. Between the husband and wife, one person is sufficient to execute this devotional service. Because of their good relationship, both of them will enjoy the result. Therefore, if the wife is unable to execute this process, the husband should carefully do so, and the faithful wife will share the result. Ardhangini, whatever you do, Prabhu, she is going to benefit always. Half of it, maybe most of the time, all of it. One should accept this Vishnu Vrat, which is the vow of devotional service, and should not deviate from its execution to engage in anything else. By offering the remnants of prasad, flower garland, sandalwood pulp and ornaments, one should daily worship the brahmanas and worship women who peacefully live with their husbands and children. Association. Every day the wife must continue following the regulative principles to worship Lord Vishnu with great devotion. Thereafter, Lord Vishnu should be laid in his bed and then one should take prasad. In this way, husband and wife will be purified and will have all their desires fulfilled. The chaste wife must perform such devotional service continuously for 1 year. After 1 year passes, she should fast on the full moon day in the month of Kartik, October, November. What a coincidence. There's no coincidence. You have been selected, chosen by the Lord. The Lord is so merciful. On the morning of the next day, one should wash oneself. And after worshipping Lord Krishna as before, one should cook as one cooks, as stated in the Griha Sutras. Sweet rice should be cooked with ghee, and with this preparation, the husband should offer oblations to the fire 12 times. That's what Prabhuji just did. Thereafter, he should satisfy the Brahmanas. When the satisfied Brahman bestow their blessings, he should devotedly offer them respectful obeisances with his head. With their permission, he should take prasad. Before taking his meal, the husband must first sit the acharya comfortably, and along with his relatives and friends should control his speech and offer prasad to the guru. Then the wife should eat the remnants of the oblation of sweet rice cooked with ghee. Eating the remnants ensures a learned, devoted son and all good fortune. If this vow or ritualistic ceremony is observed according to the description of Shastra, even in this life, a man will be able to achieve all the benedictions he desires from the Lord. A wife who performs this ritualistic ceremony will surely receive good fortune, opulence, sons, a long-living husband, a good reputation and a good home. No doubt, Mataji is in a good home. Now, for the girls who are not married till now, if an unmarried girl observes this rite, she will be able to get a very good husband. If a woman who is avira, who has no husband or son, executes this ritualistic ceremony, she can be promoted to the spiritual world. A woman whose children have died after birth can get a child with long duration of life and also become very fortunate in possessing wealth. If a woman is unfortunate, she will become fortunate, and if ugly, she will become beautiful. By observing this rod, a diseased man can get relief, gain relief from his disease and have an able body to which with which it to work. If one recites this narration while offering oblations to the pitas and demigods, especially during the Shraddh ceremony, the demigods and inhabitants of Pitrilok will be extremely pleased with him and bestow upon him the fulfillment of all desires. After one performed this ritualistic ceremony, Lord Vishnu and his wife, Mother Lakshmi, the goddess of fortune, are very pleased with him. O King Parikshit, now I have completely described how deity performed this ceremony and have good children, the Maruts, and a happy life. I have tried to explain this to you as elaborately as possible. The Grandraj for Bhagavatam Ki, the Guru Srila Prabhupada Ki, Gaur Pranande, Kirtanya Sada Hari. Hello, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare.
Krishna Krishna Hare Hare.
Now we go to the next ceremony. Shrimad Bhagavatam ceremony. Prabhu is going to Bhagyo to
Hare Hare.
So we have our
Krishna Hare Hare.
My God, it's
Rama Hare.
Krishna Kunal.
What's up? 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 What's up
Thank you. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Mantrahinam kriyahinam bhaktihinam janardhanayat pujitam vaya deva paripurnam tadastume
యథక్తమక్తి మాత్రేణ పత్రం పుష్పం ఫలంతరం ఆవిదితం నివేదం సూత గృహాన కంపయా విధీన మంత్రహీనం యత్కించిత్ ఉపాదితం క్రియామంత్ర విలంబా తత్సర్వం శంతుమరసి జ్ఞానాథ వాజ్ఞానాథ శుభం యన్మే ఆకృతం శంతుమరసి తత్సర్వం దాసినే గృహాన్ మాం స్థితి సేవామి త్రయాత్ర స్మృతి చింతా స్తుతి వచ భూయాత్ సర్వాత్మనా విష్ణు మదీయం ద్వై చేసితం అపరాధ సహస్రాని కృత్య హనిషం మయా దాసమితి మా వచ శ్రమసమధుసూదన ప్రతిజ్ఞతవ గోవింద నమి భక్త ప్రశ్యతి సంసిద్ధ సంసిద్ధ ప్రాణాన్ సంధారయామ్యం భోజ శిశిరాధా గురో గ్రంథ భగవాన్
కీ జై
దామోదర్ కీ
జై
శ్రీ శ్రీ కృష్ణ బలరామ కీ
జై
శ్రీ శ్రీ దామోదర్ కీ శ్రీ కార్తిక్ మాస ఉత్సవ కీ జై గురు
గోపాల్
కీ
జై
గోపమస్తి
హరి హరి
సాపనో కి ధ్యాన కీ బహుత్ ధన్యవాద హరి కృష్ణ
पूछ रही है, प्रभु जी माता जी का नाम क्या मिला दीक्षा।